गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, लेट्स कंटिन्यू आवर ग्रुप 70. द नेक्स्ट केमिकल प्रॉपर्टी इज द रिएक्टिविटी ऑफ हैलोजन विद हाइड्रोजन. सो हैलोजन्स रिएक्ट विद हाइड्रोजन टू फॉर्म हैलोजन एसिड्स एंड द एसिडिक स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ हैलोजन एसिड इंक्रीजेस फ्रॉम HF टू HI. व्हाई इज इट सो? बिकॉज इन HF देयर इज हाइड्रोजन बॉन्डिंग. ड्यू टू हाइड्रोजन बॉन्डिंग रिमूवल ऑफ H पॉजिटिव विल बी डिफिकल्ट. Whereas in case of HI, bond length will be more due to more atomic size of iodine. So H positive release will be easier. So that's why stronger acid is HI and weaker acid is the HF. Then is the stability. Stability of halogen acid decreases as we move from fluorine to iodine. This is because decrease in the bond dissociation enthalpy. So as bond dissociation enthalpy of HI is less, so it will be less stable. Then is a boiling point. HF has the highest boiling point. Why? Again, due to the strong intermolecular hydrogen bonding. And in case of other halogen acids, we have to consider van der Waals forces, and van der Waals forces increases with increase in size. So that's why HI is having more boiling point as compared to HBr and HCl. Then next is a percentage ionic character. So percentage ionic character decreases as we move down the group. Then dipole moment decreases down the group, again due to decrease in electronegativity. Then is the reducing power. Reducing power increases down the group. Why is it so? Because HI is having less bond dissociation energy, and that's why it can easily give hydrogen and reduce others. Then next property is reactivity with metals. So halogen react with metals to form halides, metal halides. And ionic character of metal halide decreases as we move from fluorine to iodine. Why is it so? Because iodine size is bigger, so it is having more polarizability. So that's why it is more covalent rather than ionic. And halides in higher oxidation state will be more covalent than one in the lower oxidation state. Now next are the interhalogen compounds. So these are the binary compounds of two different halogen atoms having general formula XX-N. They are called as interhalogen compounds, where N is 1, 3, 5 or 7, because they can show oxidation state of plus 1, plus 3, plus 5 and plus 7. And all these are covalent compounds. Now this is very important. Interhalogen compounds are more reactive than halogens. Why is it so? Because interhalogen compound, the bond is more polar than XX bond. So they are more reactive and they are having more boiling point as compared to X2. And all are diamagnetic. Their melting points is little higher than that of halogens. Then they can form a compound of XX-, for example CLF, BRF, etc. And all of them, they are having linear shape. Then there is of type XX3-, for example CLF3, they have bent T shape. For example, in case of Cl3, Cl is in the center, it is forming 3 fluoride bonds and there will be 2 lone pair of electrons. So its shape is T shape. Then is a case for XX5-, for example ClF5. Now in ClF5, chlorine is in the center and it is square pyramidal, where there is 1 lone pair of electron. Then IF7, it is pentagonal bipyramidal, in which in center there is iodine and there are 5 bonds with fluorine, and one will be above and one will be below. That is pentagonal bipyramidal shape. Now halogen form oxide. Mostly these oxides are unstable. Now first we will do for fluorine. Fluorine is forming two oxides, OF2, O2F2, where fluorine has oxidation state of minus 1 and OF2 is the stable out of these two. And both are fluorinating agents. They will react with plutonium to form plutonium F6. That is, they fluorinate plutonium and they help in removing plutonium from spent fuel. Chlorine, bromine, iodine, they show plus 1, plus 3, plus 5, plus 7 oxidation state in their oxides. And stability of oxide of iodine is more than is chlorine, and bromine oxides are least stable. So why oxides of iodine is more stable because there is greater polarizability of bond due to large size of iodine. So they are more stable. Then is for the chlorine. Chlorine can form multiple bond with oxygen. That's why oxides of chlorine are also stable. And bromine is not able to show both these things. So that's why its oxides are less stable. Then oxides of chlorine such as Cl2O, ClO2, Cl2O6, Cl2O7, they are very reactive oxidizing agent and they can explode. Now ClO2, it can act as bleaching agent for bleaching paper, pulp, then ivory, and it is also used for treatment of water. And oxides of bromine, they are least stable. Now next is chlorine. So first of all, its preparation. It can be prepared by any one of the methods. So first is, it can be prepared by heating manganese dioxide with concentrated HCl, then also we will get chlorine. However, mixture of common salt and H2SO4 could be also taken in place of HCl. Even then, chlorine is being liberated. It can be also formed by reacting KMnO4 with HCl, then also we get chlorine. Then they can be manufactured by Deccan process. This is by the oxidation of the hydrogen chloride gas in presence of catalyst such as copper chloride. Then we get the chlorine. Then it can also be prepared by passing electricity through brine solution, that is concentrated NaCl solution. So when we pass electricity through it, we will get chlorine, which will be liberated at anode. Then are there its properties. It is a greenish yellow gas with pungent and suffocating odor and 2.5 times heavier than air. Now next is, chlorine reacts with number of metals and non-metals to form corresponding chlorides. For example, it reacts with aluminium to form AlCl3, sodium chloride, iron FeCl3, and it can combine with non-metals such as phosphorus and sulfur to form PCl3 and S2Cl. Now it has great affinity for hydrogen. It reacts with hydrogen. For example, there is formation of hydrogen chloride. So when it reacts with the hydrogen, it also combines with the hydrogen sulfide to form HCl and sulfur. Then with the hydrocarbon, it also reacts to form HCl and carbon. Now this is very important reaction, that is reaction with sodium hydroxide, cold and dilute alkali, hot and concentrated alkali. So what is there? When it reacts with the cold and dilute alkali, there is formation of corresponding chloride and hypochlorite. And if it is reacting with hot and concentrated alkali, there is formation of chloride and chlorate. For example, if it reacts with cold and dilute sodium hydroxide, there is formation of sodium chloride and NaOCl, sodium hypochlorite. And if it reacts with the hot and concentrated NaOH, then there is formation of NaCl and sodium chlorate. So these reactions have come last year in the paper. Then this is also important, that with dry slaked lime, it is forming bleaching powder. That when chlorine is passed through dry slaked lime, there is formation of bleaching powder, calcium oxychloride, calcium chloride and water. Now chlorine reacts with hydrocarbons also, that is by substitution reaction. It replaces hydrogen and there is formation of corresponding alkyl halides. Then this is also very important thing, that is chlorine water on standing loses its yellow color due to the formation of what, that is HCl and HOCl, that is hypochlorous acid. And this hypochlorous acid, it dissociates to form HCl and nascent oxygen. And this nascent oxygen is responsible for its bleaching action. Now it is there, it is a chlorine is powerful bleaching agent, is due to oxidation. As it is due to oxidation, so it is a permanent effect. So it bleaches vegetable or organic matter to colorless substance. Then chlorine oxidizes also. It has oxidizing nature. It will oxidize ferrous to ferric ions, then sulfide to sulfate. Then it is changing sulfur dioxide to H2SO4, or it can also change it into sulfur trioxide. And iodine in presence of water is changed into, that is, iodic acid. Now is its uses. It has bleaching action, so it is used for bleaching wood pulp and manufacture of paper and rayon, and it is bleaching cotton and textiles. It also helps in extraction of gold and platinum, and it is used in the manufacture of dyes, drugs and organic compounds such as CCl4, CHCl3, DDT, refrigerants, that is freons. Then in sterilizing water, again due to its oxidizing nature, then preparation of poisonous gases such as phosgene, then tear gas and mustard gas. So it can be used to prepare these gases. So do tell here, we will take next topic tomorrow. Thank you.